Cipe Pineles, graphic designer and art director, presented by McKenna Kowalski.
Yes, it's a good day for singing a song, and it's a good day for moving along. Yes, it's a good day. How could anything be wrong? A good day from morning till night.
In 1908, Cipe was born in Vienna, Austria. In 1915, Cipe moves to the U.S. at 13 years old, alongside her mother and sisters. During her travel, Cipe wrote an essay about her departure from Eastern Europe and her arrival in the U.S., which won an award for the Atlantic Monthly. Once arriving in New York, she attended high school in Brooklyn, already showing her creative abilities. In 1926, she enrolled in Pratt in Brooklyn, where she studied fine art and obtained a Lewis Comfort Timpani Foundation scholarship. In 1929, Cipe graduates from Pratt Institute. After graduation is what she calls her adventurous years in still life painting. She also begins working at Contempora. Her career began in the commercial realm and continued to anchor itself primarily in print media and client work. While doing this, she privately kept books of full ingredients and recipes. In 1933, Cipe becomes an assistant to the art director of Condé Nast Productions after her work at Contempora is noticed. Pineles works at Condé Nast for many years and simultaneously taught in the design department at Parsons. She stayed at Condé Nast long enough to become a 10-year test case of the Art Directors Club admission policy towards women, and did in fact become the first woman member. In 1944, Cipe becomes art director at Glamour magazine.
Good morning, sun. Good morning, sun. Rise and shine today.
In 1947, Cipe becomes art director for 17 magazine. Through her time working for magazines, she brings fine artists into mass-produced media. She managed to bring both her food-related work and that of others into her art for magazines such as 17, Charm, Glamour, Vogue, and Vanity Fair. A painting she created of potatoes, which bordered a spread in 17 magazine, won an award for Art Directors Club in 1948. In 1948, Cipe becomes the first woman member of the New York Art Directors Club. Cipe was a pioneer, not only because she was a woman in a typically male profession, but because she had a vision for innovation and wasn't afraid to make it happen. Cipe was part of a community of wildly talented designers, art directors, editors, and artists. She is often remembered for the wonderful parties she'd throw for her friends and family. In 1950, Cipe becomes art director of Street Smith Charms, or Charm Magazine. Willow is tall, violets kisses, two lips recall. How can I choose one? I love them all, still I finally chose an American Beauty Rose. At Charm Magazine, her and editor Helen Valentine redirected the publication to a new consumer market, Women Who Work. In 1961, she leaves Charm Publications to work as an independent designer and illustrator. She became design consultant to Lincoln Center in 1967, with the entire graphics program of the center, from stationery to annual reports, under her supervision. Her assignments there also included symbol design and monthly journal and calendar events. The Parsons Bread Book, produced as a class project, was republished by Harper and Row in 1974. The original student version, Bread, was included in the 1974 American Institute of Graphic Arts prestigious 50 Books of the Year show. 1975, she becomes the first woman in the ACD Hall of Fame. 1998, she's awarded AIGA Gold Medal. And in 2017, Cipe's recipe sketchbook is published. This is done 72 years after it was finished. Her career is remembered as one of the most highly acclaimed magazine art directors and graphic designers in the country. Her style is remembered as being playful and modernist, which developed through uses of image and type. Cipe considered her teenage readers thoughtful and serious, rejecting stereotypes of the time. And to quote her, "We tried to convey the attractiveness of reality, as opposed to the glitter of a never-never land." I know I lost heaven, 'cause you were the song.